Cincinnati College of Mortuary Science (CCMS) is a primarily two-year, non-profit, private mortuary science college, located adjacent to St. Xavier High School just outside Cincinnati in Finneytown, Ohio, USA. CCMS is the oldest school of its kind in the United States, tracing its history back to the Clark School, which organized its first class on March 8, 1882. The school was later called the Cincinnati College of Embalming, arriving at the present name in 1966. CCMS offers associate's degrees and bachelor's degrees in mortuary science. Topic: College history. During the early periods of embalming in the United States, it became necessary to teach the skills required for new and reliable embalming techniques. To meet the need for training, a man named Joseph Henry Clark founded a school of embalming at the corner of Park and 6th Streets in Cincinnati, Ohio. Born November 28, 1840 in Connersville, Indiana, Clark later would be known as the father of American embalming schools. After a period of working in his brother's pharmacy, Clark studied medicine in Keokuk, Iowa, at about the time the Civil War broke out. Eventually, he was permitted by the Union Army to serve in the position of assistant hospital steward in the 5th Iowa Infantry. His brother-in-law, Dr. W. Darrow, allowed him to help with amputations and visiting sick wards. After the war, Clark became a casket salesman for the Whitewater Valley Coffin Company and began to realize the need for better methods of preservation for human bodies. To learn more, he enrolled in an anatomy course taught in Cincinnati by Dr. C. M. Lukens at the Poulter Medical College. Together they worked out the ideas for a school of embalming. Their schooling began as a demonstration of newly developed embalming chemicals along with rudimentary teaching of arterial and venous embalming techniques. The success of their classes was based on what the students could learn as well as the quality of products sold. The first class was organized Monday, March 8, 1882, and ended Saturday, March 13, 1882. 6 days of intensive training were held in the amphitheater of Poulter Medical College at 7th and Mound Streets. The original class consisted of 7 students. They were Frank Waterman, Boston, Massachusetts; George Thomas, Milwaukee, Wisconsin; J.F. McCormick, Mount Vernon, Ohio; George Butler, Cumberland, Maryland; John Arnold, Zanesville, Ohio; William Taylor, Paris, Kentucky; and William Greer, Oxford, Ohio. After attending the demonstrations at the amphitheater, students were presented with 8x10 certificates from the Clark School. The certificates were signed by C. M. Lukens, principal and Poulter professor of anatomy, Joseph Henry Clark, and C. M. Eppley, lecturers and demonstrators. Following the second class, Clark was financially able to make the school a permanent institution of learning. The second class was organized April 24, 1882, at the Poulter Medical College with 10 students. The school gained its first public recognition when a trade paper published the class material. The third class was organized June 6, 1882, with only 6 students. In addition, the fourth class, organized July 11, contained the same number of students, but it was conducted at Dr. Lukens' office on Race Street. The fifth class, organized September 19, became the second largest class of that year with 16 students. The sixth class was the last class of 1882 that was conducted in Cincinnati. It was organized November 7 with 4 students and was held at the Eclectic Medical College at Court and Plum Streets. To broaden the knowledge of students and to stimulate interest in the school, Professor Clark and his colleagues traveled to 3 larger cities. The first stop was Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, on November 22, 1882, where a class was held with 15 students. It was held in a hallway over a drugstore at 11th and Market Streets in Philadelphia. Following the Philadelphia adventure, the school moved on to New York City, where, on December 1, 1882, the school encountered its largest class. It contained 17 students, and the lectures were given in a society hall. As the year-end approached, the Clark School of Embalming proceeded to conduct its last few classes of the year. One was in Boston on December 11, and the other was in New York City for a second time. The year of 1882 was prosperous. Having taught 106 students in four major cities, Mr. Clark stated that, "This ended our first year's effort to convince the people that embalming was a successful way of preserving the human dead." Coincidentally, the year 1882 was also the founding year for the National Funeral Directors Association. As the Clark School continued over the next few years, other schools began to develop. Their enrollments were boosted by various state laws that required licensing of embalmers. Schooling often consisted of a system of memorizing questions and model answers for licensing exams. The result was that many students were licensed without having proper knowledge. The early courses consisted of anatomy, sanitary science, and embalming. In 1909, the ownership and management of Clark's school was secured by Charles O. Doni, under whom it acquired its status as the Cincinnati College of Embalming. Mr. Doni was born on March 23, 1886 in Cincinnati. Early on, he decided to enter the career of funeral service and work in his father's funeral home at Knowlton's Corner. But after the two-week period of instruction, Charles was dissatisfied with the length and depth of the program. He believed that mortuary education should be improved and expanded and, therefore, decided to enter the field of education. Clark himself was soon to retire, and he encouraged Doni to accept the challenge of teaching and taking over the college. Doni accepted his advice and purchased the college in 1909. Over the years, it became clear that Doni was very concerned about the educational and licensing system and wrote, "Whatever a student really understood was secondary to his ability to memorize." He sought to change this philosophy and in doing so stated, "When one has learned to know and understand, learned to think through the use of suitable thinking instrumentalities, one may more intelligently apply what one has learned to know and has developed the ability to do." 6 years later, Doni moved the college to the General Hospital in Cincinnati, where the large number of hospital cases gave students the experience that was required. In 1919, more classroom and office space was assigned to the college at the General Hospital to accommodate larger class sizes. Even though additional space was allocated, classes were still too large for the hospital. In 1933, Doni moved the administrative offices and classrooms into a newly remodeled Arts and Science building at 3200 Reading Road. The space was greatly appreciated when the college enrolled the largest classes in its history shortly after World War II. In 1954, Mr. Doni continued to promote that mortuary education consisted of more than simply memorizing questions and their model answers. He said, "Since 1909, it has been our opinion, here at Cincinnati, that a mortuary college can be an educational institution rather than a state examination coaching facility, and we have never lost sight of that academic point." To support his vision of competence and education in funeral service, Doni established a cooperative relationship with the University of Cincinnati for general studies and professional subjects. In 1966, Doni changed the name of the college to the Cincinnati College of Mortuary Science. By fostering an atmosphere of support for research and publication, Doni also stimulated productivity in the faculty. Over the years, some 20 books were written by CCMS faculty, and several patents were produced at the college. Among the books was the series written by Doni and Dr. A.J. Nunnemaker on Anatomy for Embalmers, Hygiene and Sanitary Science, Manual of Case Analysis, Manual of Restorative Art, Personalities in Funeral Management, and Dissecting Guide for Embalmers. In 1940, Thomas Stuver, a Cincinnati attorney and member of the CCMS faculty, wrote Mortuary Law, which has become a standard in funeral service and in funeral service education. In 1985, Mr. James Dawn, CCMS faculty member and chairman of Embalming Sciences, and Dr. Barbara Hopkins, chairperson of the Xavier University Chemistry Department, co-authored and published Thanatochemistry, which is the standard chemistry textbook in funeral service education. As the years progressed, Mr. Donai came to believe that a small proprietary college would need broader support if it were to survive. In the late 1960s, he worked with Thomas Stuver, and they formed the Cincinnati Foundation for Mortuary Education, a private, non-profit 501(c)(3) organization that would support the Cincinnati College of Mortuary Science. In 1970, Mr. Donai transferred all personal assets and responsibility to the foundation. When Donai retired, Dr. George M. Sleichter became director of the institution. Sleichter had served CCMS for over 40 years as a faculty member and chemistry teacher. In 1975, owing to health problems, Dr. Sleichter resigned, and Mr. David Fitzsimmons was appointed president of CCMS early in 1976. Fitzsimmons reorganized the college, renewed its faculty, and conducted a revision of the curriculum. Soon after he arrived, Fitzsimmons negotiated a 2- and 4-year degree program with Edgecliffe College in addition to the CCMS 1-year diploma program. The association with Edgecliffe College gave CCMS new opportunities for growth. Indiana 1979, CCMS moved from 3200 Reading Road to 2220 Victory Parkway on the Edgecliffe campus under the terms of a lease agreement. The new surroundings offered campus life but still recognized CCMS as a distinctive and separate college. 1 year later, Xavier University purchased Edgecliffe College and changed the name to the Edgecliffe campus of Xavier University. In 1980, CCMS received authorization from the Ohio Board of Regents to award the Associate of Applied Science degree, and in 1982 it received accreditation of that degree by the North Central Association of Colleges and Schools. In 1986, CCMS became the first private college of mortuary science in the nation to be authorized to award the Bachelor of Mortuary Science degree. In 1987, CCMS was accredited by the North Central Association and by the American Board of Funeral Service Education at the bachelor's degree level. In 1994, because of continued growth, CCMS purchased 16 acres of land in suburban Cincinnati and built its own permanent home. CCMS moved into the state-of-the-art facilities in 1995. Topic. Notable alumni. Roger Blackwell, honorary marketing expert and public speaker. Ryan McClinn, former mayor of Dayton, Ohio. Charlie Wilson, member of the U.S. House of Representatives from Ohio's 6th Congressional District.